Shalom, everyone.
Shabbat shalom.
Welcome to Song of Songs Shabbat, and I'm very excited to share what that means. But before we go further, I just would like to remind you to turn off your cell phones or turn them to mute so they don't interrupt the flow and the vibe of Shabbat. And to begin the flow and vibe of Shabbat, turn to someone, maybe someone you don't know, and wish them Shabbat Shalom. So, why did we choose Song of Songs Shabbat? Because next week we are entering into the month, the Hebrew month of Elul. Now, Elul is the month that is right before Rosh Hashanah. And traditionally, it's the month when we begin to take an account of ourselves, to ask forgiveness. Traditionally, if you're going to your morning services, they blow the shofar every single morning to start to get you to wake up and think about your life. However, Elul also is an acronym for a beautiful Hebrew phrase that is in the book, The Song of Songs. Ani ledodi vedodi li. I am my beloved, and my beloved is mine. Now, a lot of you don't know about the Song of Songs. It's in the third section of the Hebrew Bible, and it's totally different from anything else. And there was a big debate because it's sensual, erotic, evocative, and beautiful. And we're going to, I'm going to share some things about it and read some of the beautiful poetry in it. So we begin with a beautiful duet from Song of Songs. It's not from Song of Songs, but it's a love. It's love. It's got love in it. So we begin with this beautiful duet.
Join us in Hine Matob, and we'll go into the duet from there.
Hine matov manayim shavetachim gam yachad. Hine matov manayim shavetachim gam yachad. Hine matov shavetachim gam yachad. Thank you.
that was not from Song of Songs, but it's a great contrast because basically what they were singing is a psalm that says, I lift my eyes to the hills or the mountains, where is my help? And they look toward God. The Song of Songs has no mention of God at all. It's about a story about two lovers, a young shepherd and a young shepherdess, and their passion for each other and the way they express their love to each other. The rabbis, this was a very, very popular, beloved series of songs and poems, and the rabbis wanted to include it, but they didn't quite know how. And this was one of their dilemmas, but they figured out a way. So we will continue with that, but first I'd like to invite Joni Reisman to come up and light the Shabbat candles as we turn to page 2.
As Joni kindles those flames, let's use our arms, our hands to gather that light up, bring it toward ourselves as we offer the blessing.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu
Asur. But we're only required to have one candle. It's not acceptable. According to Reb Nanus, it's not acceptable. But I think we are only required. Oh, look at that. She's got it. She's an expert.
No, I got lighter.
Thank goodness. Teamwork.
I agree. So, as I said, Anila Dodi Vidodi Li means I am my beloved and my beloved is mine. And the word Dodi is in Lecha Dodi. There's love and it's inspired perhaps by the same concept. Lecha Dodi, let's go, my beloved. Likrat Kala, to welcome the bride. Pnei Shabbat, the face or the presence of Shabbos. Nakabala, we will receive. So we're all each other's beloveds tonight as we sing Lecha Dodi together and greet the Shabbat bride. Except we're going to sing first. My God. We have this outline. First, we're going to sing Dodi Li. We're actually going to sing the one, I am my beloved and my beloved is mine. So let's do that. And then we'll go right into
Rabbi Nanus.
What?
Did you notice the name of the composer for this Dodi Li?
It's Susan Rosenstein?
It is.
Wow.
It's our own Susan Rosenstein. And her beloved, for whom this was written, is sitting in the congregation.
Oh, that's beautiful.
So you talked about the bride for whom this is written. We have one representative here for whom this was written. I think many of us are representatives being beloved by someone else. That's the feeling we want to hold on to at Shabbat. So we sing these words of Dodi Li.
Dodi Li. Mizu shoshanim dodi li vani laharoha bashoshanim.
I am my beloved's, my beloved is mine, a shepherd among the roses. We continue with Lecha Dodi on page 20. So Rabbi Akiva, was one of our greatest Talmudic scholars, said about the Song of Songs, and I want to read the quote. The whole world is not as worthy as the day on which the Song of Songs was given to Israel. For all the writings are holy, but the Song of Songs is the holy of holies. So Rabbi Akiva was comparing the Song of Songs to the innermost sanctum in the temple as the holiest place. Now, Rabbi Akiva had an amazing love story, and so I understand why he loved the Song of Songs. Rabbi Akiva was a poor, ignorant shepherd, and he was working for the richest man in his town, and this man had one daughter who he wanted to marry off to a very wealthy husband, and she fell in love with Akiva. She saw something in him, and she said, I want to marry you, and I want you to go and study Torah. And her father said, if you marry him, I'm disowning you. And she married him anyway. And so they were so poor. They were so poor, they were scraping by. And then Rabbi Akiva had an opportunity to go and study everything, Torah, everything. And there's one story that says she actually taught him how to read and then sent him on his way. He, by the way, became one of our greatest Talmudic scholars. So he went away for 12 years. And she was scraping by. And then he was coming back, and he heard through the window somebody talking to her and saying, "How can you let your husband be gone for 12 years? She says, "I believe in him so much, he could study for another 12 years. So what do you think he did? He went away for another 12 years. So 24 years later, he comes back, followed by all these disciples and students. He's become one of the greatest Talmudic scholars. And here's this poor, aged woman standing on the road waiting to greet him, and the students say, "Get out of the way, old lady. You know, let the great, great rabbi pass." And he says, "This woman is everything to me." And he recognized his beautiful wife, and the tradition says he had a gold crown, like headpiece made for her, which was the skyline of Jerusalem. It's like this famous tiara that he gave her. So Rachel and Akiva is a great love story, and he also is the rabbi who said of the whole Torah, the most important thing is love your neighbor as yourself. So I see him as a lover, okay? So he loved Song of Songs. However, Song of Songs, as you're going to hear a little later, is a very lusty, erotic set of poetry. And he also said later on, whoever sings the Song of Songs in the taverns will not go to the next world or will not go to heaven, meaning they were singing it in the taverns. That's what we know. And we also know that there are two times a year. I don't know how many of you know there is an ancient Israelite Valentine's Day, right, called Tu B'Av, which means the 15th of the month of Av, and Tu B'Av, and on Yom Kippur night, after you broke the fast, the girls of ancient Israel would dress in white and go to outside the walls of Jerusalem, dancing for the boys, looking for a suitor, singing the Song of Songs. So this is like the background to the Song of Songs. And everybody tried to reinterpret it. I'm going to read you the interpretations, and then I'm going to read you the song, and you tell me if you agree with the interpretations. But now we continue on page 28 as we rise for the Baruch Hu. Page 30. Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, ruler of the universe, who speaks the evening into being, skillfully opens the gates, thoughtfully alters the time and changes the seasons, and arranges the stars in their heavenly courses according to plan. You are creator of day and night, rolling light away from darkness and darkness from light, transforming day into night and distinguishing one from the other. Adonai Tzvaot is your name, ever-living God. May you reign continually over us into eternity. you, Adonai, who brings on the evening.
Baruch atah Adonai, ha-mariv aravim.
So another word in Hebrew for love is ahava. And we have ahava all over our Shabbat service on page 32. Ahavat olam, everlasting, eternal love that God gives his people Israel. Please be seated and join us as we continue with the Via Hafta on page 36.
Via Hafta et Adonai Elohecha Bechol levavecha uvechol nafshecha uvechol meodecha Vehayu hadvarim haele Asher anochi mitzavecha Hayom al levavecha, v'shinantam levanecha, v'dibarta baham, v'shivtecha beveitecha, uvelechtecha vaderech, uveshochbecha uvekumecha, ukshartam lehot al yadecha, v'hayu letotafot b'ineinecha, וכתבתם על מזיזות ביתך ובישריך למען תזכרו עשיתם את כל מצוותי ויתם קדושים לאלוהיכם אני אדוני אלוהיכם אשר הוצאתי אתכם מארץ מצרים להיות לכם לאלוהים, אני אדוני אלוהיכם.
So just to emphasize love again, let's read the English of this. You shall love Adonai your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. Take to heart these instructions which I charge you this day. Impress them upon your children. Recite them when you stay at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you get up. Bind them as a sign on your hand, and let them serve as a symbol on your forehead. Inscribe them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. Thus you shall remember to observe all my commandments and be holy to your God. I am Adonai your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt to be your God. I am Adonai your God. So I wrote my master's thesis on Song of Songs, and I am convinced that it was written by a woman. And a lot of the songs in the Bible were written by women. The song of Micha Mocha, which we're about to sing, the song of the sea, is attributed mostly to Miriam, according to scholars. Deborah wrote an amazing song. Hannah wrote a song. So there is this tradition of women poets, women writers who celebrate, and usually it's about God, though. They usually thank God or celebrate some kind of victory or some kind of miracle. The Song of Songs is different in that, but perhaps it's celebrating the miracle of human relationships and human love. We continue with the original oldest song, the Song of the Sea, Micha Mocha, on page 40. That we lie down in peace and raise us up our guardian to life renewed. Spread over us the shelter of your peace. Page 42, Hashkivenu.
Birkat Shalom Aleinu Ve'al Kol Amo Yisrael Ve'al Yerushalayim.
We turn to page 46 and we rise for the Amidah. This is a standing prayer where we have an opportunity to pray together and then pray privately for what we need this week.
Adonai sefatai tiftach ufi agite hilatecha Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu velohe avotenu vimoteinu Elohe Avraham, Elohe Yitzchak, Elohe Yaakov Elohe Sarah, Elohe Rivka Elohei Rachel ve'Elohei Leah, ha'El ha'Gadol, ha'Gibor ve'Hanora, El Elyon, komel chasadim tovim, ve'konei ha'kol, ve'zocher chasdei avot ve'imahot, u'mevi' geula livnei v'neihem, le'ma'an shemo be'ahava. Melech ozer hoshia magin Baruch ata Adonai Magin Avraham ve'ezrat Sara Ata gibur le'olam Adonai Mechayei hakol ata Rav le'hoshia Morid hatal Mechakel chayim bechesed Mechayei hakol berachamim rabim Somech noflim verofei cholim Umatir asurim Umekayem emunato Lishenei afar Michamocha bagevurot Umidomelach Melech memi Umechayeh, umatzmihach Yeshua, v'neheman atal hachayot hakol. Baruch ata Adonai, mechayeh hakol.
Pray as if everything depended on God. Act as if everything depended on you. We continue silently with the words in our prayer book and our siddur or our own private meditations. When the ark is closed, you may be seated. Words from Song of Songs. And you, my beloved, how beautiful you are. Your eyes are doves, is what he says to her. And she says to him, my dove is in the clefts of the rock, in the shadow of the cliff. Let me see you, all of you. Let me hear your voice, your delicious song. I love to look at you.
Your fall.
Thank you, Cantor. That was beautiful. We take a moment now to remember those in our lives who need a blessing of healing as we prepare to say the Misha Be'erach prayer. Physical healing, spiritual healing, emotional healing. Is there someone in your life that you would like to receive this blessing? Please stand up, and when I come to you, say their name out loud so that we may all hear the name.
Rick Mills.
Josh Mills.
Kale Weisel, Sadie Weisel, Sadie Bernstein.
Sheila Miller and Ron Miller.
Karen and Sarah, Lily, and Helen B. Rosen, and George Malloy and Judith Pulver and Paulette Hawkins.
I thought it's a Shabbat blessing.
That's okay. It's okay.
Roz Weissman.
Doris Rubelson and the island of Maui and the big island and all the people there.
Yes, the island of Maui, yes.
Sarah Pell, Ned Fenton, Philip Barrett-Benassoff.
Leanne Steiner. Shirley Edwards.
Charles Kaufman, Helen Mayer.
Ted Singer.
Mike Solomon, John Maurice, Victor Mino.
And we have a lot of people at home who are watching who also need our blessings, and I'll read their names now. Nicole Alkov, Isaac Ashorzadeh, Simon Aziz, Emily Blau, Chaim David, Karen Fields, Rick Frankel, Jacob Friedman, Vicky Friedman, Merlo Gadushi, Hilly Gordon, Levi Jonathan, James Klein, Jack Liebhaber, Michael Levy, Ronald Lanicki, Philip Marber, Sheila Merowitz, Gila Meshkanian, Josh Mills, Michael Neiman, Annette Pansky, Helen Passman, Judith Ann Salter, Trevor Sangster, Charles Schwartz, Karen Chanbrum, Alan Cerotti, Merrill Werber, Stacy Wernick. Said, there was this popular poetry. And so the rabbis tried to understand what it meant. And so one of the first interpretations is, it's not really between a man and a woman, it's between God and the Jewish people. So here is the opening of this song. Kiss me. Make me drunk with your kisses. Your sweet loving is better than wine. You are fragrant. You are myrrh and aloes. All the young women want you. Take me by the hand. Let us run together. My lover, my king, has brought me into his chambers. We'll laugh, you and I, and count each kiss better than wine. Is that between God and the Jewish people? Okay. So, then they said it's God's love, or it's God in Israel, as I said. And then this idea that every single metaphor was really about the sea, Sinai, the world to come, that it wasn't really about between a man and a woman. Then there was also this idea that God is the bridegroom and the beloved bride is Israel. And that there were 10 songs created before creation, love songs, and this was one of them. Then there was another idea that the bride represented the human soul and the bridegroom was God. So it was more mystical. So, hold on. My love, I dreamed of you as a mare, my very own among Pharaoh's chariots. Your cheekbones, those looped earrings, that string of beads at your throat. I will make you golden earrings with silver filigree. At night, between my breasts, my love is a cluster of myrrh, a sheaf of henna blossoms in the vineyards of Ein Gedi. And you, my beloved, how beautiful you are. Your eyes are doves. So there's this idea they try to say that it was between the soul and God. Then the church tried to interpret it, and they said it was between Jesus and the church. And this is what it was really about. I am the rose of Sharon, the wild lily of the valleys. Like a lily in a field of thistles, such is my love among the young women. And my beloved among the young men is a branching apricot tree in the wood. In the shade I have often lingered, tasting the fruit. So then there was that idea, and they kept trying to reinterpret it. Another idea was that it was, wait, hold on, I have so many of them. That feminist women said that this was really an empowerment song about women, that it showed a woman who had a commitment to life, love, and learning, and makes the unnamed woman in the song, well, they name her Shulamit, an example of what a woman is like bent on forging a life for herself. She is headstrong, passionate, gutsy, and willing to risk the disapproval of those around her in order to pursue her own happiness. So this is a woman empowerment poem, which is a more modern idea. And she says, at night in my bed, I longed for my only love. I sought him, but did not find him. I must rise and go about the city, the narrow streets and squares, till I find my only love. I sought him everywhere, but I could not find him. So she's running around looking for her lover. Then the watchmen found me as they went to the city. Have you seen him? Have you seen the one I love? I had just passed them when I found my only love. I held him. I would not let him go until I brought him to my mother's house, into my mother's room. So, again, we see this beautiful eroticism, and this, in Sephardic tradition, is read every single Shabbat before you start Kabbalat Shabbat. And in Ashkenazi, we read it on Pesach. We read it during Pesach. So why is this such an important poem, I think? Because it, first of all, the name of my thesis was Song of Songs, A Woman's Guide to Love, Sex, and Happiness. Because I think this, what?
Catchy.
Right. I think that this song embodies what a real relationship could be. And it can be greater. It's between a man and a woman, but this idea of appreciating each other and complimenting each other and seeking each other out and supporting each other. It could also be as a community. I was thinking, when I was thinking about talking to you, like Wilshire Boulevard Temple and you are our beloved and we are yours, that we are there for you and you are there for us, and that perhaps God doesn't need to be mentioned because God is in the relationship, in the beauty and connection between people. That's where we really feel elevated and uplifted. So it's a very short little book. I suggest you go home and read it. If you have a partner, you might want to read it together. And the Kabbalists felt this was a very important support of the idea that on Shabbat you read this and then you make love to your partner. And there's actually, if I can find it, because I have so many pages here, there's a blessing that you say. There's a blessing that you say after, that basically says, behold, I have fulfilled the act of love on Shabbat, like you declare it. So that is Song of Songs, and it's just so enriching, and I wanted to share that with you. Shabbat Shalom. And now we have another. Oh, yes. So the Cantor and I were talking about, like, these beautiful poems of ancient times. What kind of songs of love do we have today? What kind of songs embody that passion, that beauty? And the Cantor is going to sing one, and maybe you'll sing along with her.
We tried to choose one. You were talking about how this is popular, right? So in language that people could really understand. So we tried to choose a song that we thought many people here might know. So.
And that would be sung in the taverns. Probably the jukebox.
Don't know much about history, don't know much biology, don't know much about science books, don't know much about the French I took, but I do know that I love you, and I know that if you love me too, what a wonderful world this would be. Don't know much about geography, don't know much trigonometry, don't know much about algebra, don't know what a slide rule is for, but I do know one and one is two, and if this one could be with you, what a wonderful world this would be. Now I don't claim to be an A student, but I'm trying to be, for maybe by being an A student, baby, I can win your love for me. Geology, science book, French I took, but I do know that I love you, and I know that if you love me too, what a wonderful world this would be.
Wouldn't it be wonderful if we all loved each other?
Shabbat Shalom.
So just a few announcements before we conclude our service. Next week is a special Shabbat, the music, magical music of Cantor Gurney, and he's going to be singing. We're going to be honoring him, and there'll be a lovely oneg, and we hope you'll all attend. It should be beautiful, and it's next week.
I'd like to thank our musicians this
yes,
evening.
Yes, let's thank them. Weren't
I'd
they beautiful?
I'd like to thank Susan Rosenstein and Leo Chelyapop and Hope Easton. Thank you so much for providing beauty, and I'd also like to thank all of our staff here on tech who are helping out to each and every one of you who's helping make you all at home be able to see us and who's providing sound for us here this evening. I also wanted to mention that our adult volunteer choir met for the first time for this season last night. If you didn't make it but you still want to come, there's still room, so you can still join. I see people who were here last night who are here today. If you still would like to be part of our choir, there's still room for you. You can come on Thursday at 7 p.m. from 7 to 8:30 under the baton of Susan Rosenstein, and join myself and Susan for joining together and raising our voices in song.
Just one more thing. Is there anybody who's here for the first time? Anybody here for the first time? Because we want to welcome you. No. Well, that's good. So you're here for more than the first time. Great. So we're going to turn now to thoughts of memory as we prepare for Kaddish. And it is our tradition that if you're observing the first 30 days, the first 11 months, or a Yahrzeit, to please stand, that we may know who you are. We remember, we start with the remembering those who passed away during Shloshim, the past 30 days. Max Aronson, William Friedkin, Claire Goldstein, Sarah Rose Lafer, Ruth Levine, Joseph Makram, Judy Michaels, George Morgan, Gloria Ruth, Ronnie Shapiro, Patsy Sultan, and Gail Weiner. We also remember those whose Yahrzeits took place this past week, the anniversaries of their deaths. Joanne Alfred, Joseph Ansel, Rose Bagelman, Barbara Lerner Barrett, David Bagelman, Pauline Bernstein, Gabriel Bezar, Shakrola Bina, Stanley Blatt, Louis Bolmott, Dorothy Cam Borenstein, Eugene Borson, Seymour Brostoff, Kenneth Miles Burke, Billy Burns, Linda Jane Cherry, Jean Davidow, Anna Julia Bonici de Ferrero, Lawrence Deitch, Jerry DeFalco, Sam Delinko, Aiden Edwards, June Ellen, Frank Feiler, Disa Freilich, Evelyn Friedman, Joyce Friedman, Beverly Friedman, Lillian Garr, Irving Geffner, Edward Gelb, Elsie Goodman, Michael Harris, Sidney Hoffman, Anthony Amarco, Hattie Isaacs, Muriel Jackson, Marie Kalman, Jonas Benton Kelsall, Belle Kessler, Evelyn Kessler, Ben Cockhob, Vivian Korn, Michael Crevin, Solomon David Kugler, Judith Wolfley, Lawrence Leonard, Margaret Lesak, Abe Linker, Sam Lipow, Pearl Loderman, Jenny Markowitz, Sydney Mayer, Anna Mitchell, Maurice Nahum, Brian Nelson, Fran Newberg, Lillian Ott, Larry Phillips, Beatrice Polavoy, William Poltok, Sylvia Post, Lillian Price, Thelma Prince, Teresa Rouse, Gustav Reese, Edith Rogers, Isidore Rosenberg, Jenny Rubens, Herbert Rubin, Leonard Saxon, Ruth Shapira, Michael Schwartz, Evelyn Schwartz, Nathan Schaffer, Raquel Shanbrom, Stanley Sherman, Wilfred Shohan, Ida Siegel, Lillian Silver, Gilda Spiegel, Len Steckler, Rodolfo Susha Wetsky, Marion Tashman, Benjamin Teitelman, Abe Tobias, Stephen Tomar, Alice Walker, Rose Wegg, Marie Weinstein, Jack Yablon, Sumner Yaffe, Moshe Aaron Young, Elaine Zane, Alvin Sapersky. Are there any names to add? Thank you. Anyone else? Thank you. Did you have? Thank you. Thank you. Anyone else? Thank you. Thank you. We also remember those who gave their lives defending the United States of America, the State of Israel, those who have perished in the fires on Maui, those who have died from senseless war across the world, disease, and those who have no one to say Kaddish for them. We take them all as our own, as we all rise and turn to page 294 for the Kaddish. Yitgadal v'yitgadash shemei rabba, v'yelma divrach v'agrute v'yamlich machute, v'chayechon uv'yomechon uv'chaye d'chol beit Yisrael, v'agala v'yizman kari v'imru amen. Yehei Shmei Rabbah Mevarach Le'olam Omei Omaya Yitbarach V'yishtabach V'yitbar V'yitromam V'yitnaseh V'yitadar V'yitaleh V'yitalal Shmei Dekudishah Brichu Le'ela Mikol B'yarchata V'shirata Tushpachata V'nechemata Damiran V'yalma V'yimru Amen Yehei Shlama Rabbah Min Shemaya V'chaim Aleinu V'yal Kol Yisrael V'yimru Amen Ose Shalom B'mramav Hu Yaseh Shalom Aleinu V'yal Kol Yisrael V'yimru Amen Ose Shalom
And Motzi, I'd like to invite Jeanette to come join me once more. She's not a bat mitzvah, or she is a bat mitzvah, but she's been a bat mitzvah for a while. But I wanted to thank this wonderful young woman who comes and sings with us from time to time, Jeanette Mills. And we'll join together in Kiddush on page 5. To invite Lynn Wiseman and Judy Pies to come up and do the motzi.
I will happily lead you.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam hamotzi lechem min haaretz. Amen.
B'tei Avon and Shabbat Shalom.